Hello there, I'm Luca Ricci and I'm a musician. Today I'm going to teach you something about music semiology. What is music semiology? Music semiology is the study of the symbols used to translate graphically every musical sound, representing their different acoustic parameters by the rules and conventions of music notation. So, what are those acoustic parameters that I mentioned earlier? To know that, I must tell you first what sound is. Sound is the effect of the vibrations of an elastic body that are transmitted by the vehicle surrounding it, such as air or water. It has various parameters that I'm going to define. Height, the frequency of the sound. It tells us if the sound is a high sound or a low sound. Intensity, the amplitude of the sound, if it is loud or quiet. Timbre or color, the form of the sound wave. It tells us what instrument is playing that sound. Length, it is the duration of the sound, if it is a long sound or a short sound. All those parameters are then expressed graphically with the use of a particular type of graphic, the pentagram. The pentagram, or staff, is a set of 5 lines and 4 spaces that represent a frequency time graphic. The staff is used completely for music notation, using even the spaces below the first line and above the fifth. Inside the pentagram, there are symbols that we call notes. In traditional music theory, the basic notes are 7, ordered by eighth, following the lowest to the highest. There are 2 denomination systems for the notes, with solmization and with the alphabet. The first is widely used in countries like Italy, where the second is used in Anglo-Saxon countries. The solmization systems refer to the notes as Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Si, while the alphabet system refers to them as A, B, C, D, E, F, G. The main difference between those 2 systems is the starting point of the notes. In the solmization systems, the notes start with Do or Si, while in the Anglo-Saxon system, they start with A or La. In the next episode, I will teach you how to place notes inside a staff and the importance of the various clefs. So stay tuned. See you there!